There are some tricky parts in construction of the tube H. One of them is how to make electrical connection between the stem and the digits. The electrical connection is not such a problem, it's just a piece of wire, but the real problem is how to make a reliable insulation so that this connection doesn't glow. Here we have the glass stem. This is the place where the wires go through the glass and brings the electrical signals into the tube. Here are the tungsten wires and they end here at this place. And we need to take these electrical signals from here to the digits, which will be here. They will have a connection taps like here, protruding through the ceramic insulators. So we need to bring the electrical connection from here to this point. Like there will be 10 wires and here will be five taps on this side and five taps on the other side. Making the electrical connection is not such a problem. We can just spot weld wire from here to here and that's it. But the problem is that if we leave it like this, the wire will glow as well, because there is also potential between this wire, which is negative, and this anode plate, which is positive. To prevent this glow, we need to make some kind of insulation on this wire like this, so that this insulation prevents the wire from glowing. There are several criteria for the insulation. First of them, the insulation must have low vapor pressure. So this means that it should not contain any volatile compounds which could evaporate from the insulation into the vacuum during processing or later during operation of the tube. This is the most important criteria which determines the lifespan of the tube. Another criteria is that this insulation must withstand 500 degrees of Celsius. This is the temperature what we use during the bake-out process, and at this temperature it still must be stable and not evaporate. And the last important thing is we will bend the wire during the installation, so it must stick to the substrate, must stick well to the wire underneath. The problem is that if you use a ceramic coating or something like this, it's very brittle, so it tends to peel off from the wire. So this insulation must stick well to the wire and it must enable us to be able to install the wire inside the tube. Before reinventing the wheel, let's have a look at how the old engineers did it in case of the old Nixie tubes. So in case of this Nixie tube, there is no insulation at all. You can see that the wires here are shiny metallic, so there is simply no insulation. And you can also see that there is a dark deposit under the wires and on the glass. This is the evaporated metal, like by the sputtering process from the wires. And this means that the wires were glowing during the operation of the tube. So I don't understand much how this was meant. I got these tubes as a laboratory samples, so maybe these are not production tubes but rather samples from the Philips laboratory. I don't really know. In our current Nixie tube, you can see that we don't use any coating on the wires, and this is because the electrical field is weakened by the mica plate under the anode cage. So the electrical field here is simply not enough to make the wires glow. All the glow is concentrated inside the Nixie tube. This is IN12 Russian Nixie tube. You can see that the insulation have black color. This works reliably. I tried to overdrive it with higher current and it doesn't glow at all, so this works quite well. I don't know what they used here, because I have never seen a black colored insulation, so it would be interesting to hear your opinions if you know what this coating can be. So this we could definitely use this. Also, if you look closer at the spot welding wires, you see that the insulation is not stripped from the wire, so this means that they can spot weld the wires with the coating, like through the coating by the spot welder, which means that it's maybe at least slightly conductive. This is great because you don't need to care about the spot welding, and this would simplify the process. I found one dead iron 12 and open it, and I want to see if this insulation stick well to the wire. Yeah, it seems I can bend it and it doesn't peel off, so it seems to be flexible. You can see I'm trying to damage the coating, and you can see here already the metallic areas, but it takes some effort to remove the coating. So this sticks really well to the wire. Here we have another tube, Z560M. As you can see, they use white coating, and they also coat the endings of the wire with just a blob of ceramic adhesive or some like ceramic paste. It's here and then on the ends as well. So this is to prevent the ends of the wire where is no insulation for the spot welding. This is my opinion. When you look closer at the wire, you can see something like a spiral under the white coating. And I was thinking about this, and I think the old engineers, they took what they had by hand. And this was a filament they used in regular vacuum tubes. They already had at this time the technology for coating the tungsten filaments with alumina. So they took it and just used in the Nixie tubes. It was perfect choice because they didn't have to reinvent anything or invent anything new. From these options, I like the spiraled filament coated with alumina the best. It's a really perfect solution. It's flexible, it can withstand the temperature. It's alumina and tungsten, so it's really pure for the vacuum. Now, how to make it? It's definitely possible to make some setup for spraying the filaments with alumina. We would first need to buy the filaments, and the alumina is quite easy to make, but this would be really complicated to do. Like, this would take really long time to develop. So I thought that there must be still a company making these filaments, because the coated filaments are used in a lot of modern devices like mass spectrometers and other stuff. And so I was searching a little bit on internet, and I found a company called Union City Filaments, and they manufacture exactly what we need. Like, they do custom filaments with like custom shapes, custom coating, everything. So this is really exactly what we need. So I will now go and write them, and I will wait for the response. Maybe they will be able to manufacture the filaments for us. And while waiting for the response from the company, I will search the internet for possible other coatings. What would we apply ourselves on the plain wires? And maybe you have also experience with coating for the vacuum. So if you have any ideas, please let me know. Just write a comment in the comment section, and I will be happy to read it. Thank you so much today for watching, and see you next time at the next episode of Developing the Tube Age. Thanks.